much.
Wonderful.
Really appreciate it.
Yeah, can I just say something?
Yeah, go.
You know, one thing that I like, what I really like, is that it seemed like you guys went. That, you know, to me, that's like, right? You know, we can talk about the notes, we can talk about all that stuff, we get all that stuff together, but it's about really like sharing your love and your joy and your enthusiasm for this music, because it is like, I'm sure people in the audience, did you guys feel that? Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Did you feel that they were having fun? You see how important that is? And that's the beautiful thing about music, is that you're actually giving something to somebody. So keep it up, okay?
Now. Yeah. All right. Jump right in. I agree. It was so great to have like just so much joy and energy, and everyone feels that. It's really great. I guess we'll just go song by song,
yeah,
if that works for y'all.
Sure.
Okay, cool. On the first song, I am trying to bring my hand right. Let's go with it.
Back on that, I think that one thing that I would like to say, and this was kind of overall throughout the performance, is dynamics. What dynamic marking were we playing the entire time? What do you guys think? Huh? Come on, top quartet. Absolutely. Double forte, right? And it's like me yelling in your face continuously, right? So that's one of the beautiful things about music, is that we can arrange on the spot, even if it's not written, right? Rhythm section, as we think. You guys have so much power. You know, the drummer, you're really the leader of the band. The drummer, you guys are really the leaders of the band, right? And it's really important how you know, when you have power, you have to know how to use the power, right? And power, knowing you have so much power, that doesn't mean that you have to be in everybody's face. It means having true power is knowing when to step back. Say, hey, you got it, right? So, you guys can lead with dynamics at all times, okay? Within our sections. One thing I wanted to talk about, where are my lead players? You play lead alto? You play lead trumpet? Where's lead trombone? Okay. First of all, the first thing that you need to do is lead players need to be in the middle. You guys need to line up together, right? So I would probably have like my lead alto right smack down in the middle, right? You have to do it now. Lead trombone, right?
you should be playing lead. That's where the lead trombone player is, right? The lead trumpet player is right in the boom. So you guys are in alignment right here, okay? That's first and foremost. All right. Yeah, that's one thing, and we'll do some. You know what I was thinking? You have a beautiful way that you're dealing with the ride, both of you guys. You have, on the swing, you have one go-to rhythm. What is that rhythm?
Simple swing pattern.
Just play it for me. Right. Now tell me about, and that sounds good. Tell me about, who was, okay, you guys were doing the Miles thing, right? I'm having a senior moment. That was
Freddie.
Thank you. Who was playing drums on that?
I was.
No. I meant the recording. Miles. Did anyone tell me who's playing drums on that? Anybody in the room? No one knows.
Jimmy Cobb.
Jimmy Cobb.
Thank you. Jimmy Cobb was playing drums on that. Now, why am I asking you who was playing drums on that recording?
Style.
Right? When we're playing, and I'm not just saying you, because I think that you should know as many jazz drummers as you. You should know as many jazz vocalists as you. You should know as many jazz trombone players as you, right? And then once we're listening to that stuff, once I say, okay, well, how was Jimmy Cobb really dealing with that? You know how Jimmy Cobb was playing on that sucker? Quarter note. You know, and that's one of the beautiful things about Jimmy Cobb. That was his thing, you know. I mean, of course, he could do everything. But when we're listening, when we really start listening to all these great players, then we start thinking, oh, wait a minute. Maybe I should try that on this, okay? So, let's do some homework on that stuff that we're playing. Okay, I know you guys know, who was playing alto? Wait a minute, hold on. Who was playing alto saxophone on Freddie Freeman? Thank you very much. That shouldn't even be a question. That should be an answer automatic, okay? Not because I'm jumping on your case, but man, you guys are enjoying the music and loving it so much, I guarantee you, you will love that. I guarantee you, okay? So these are things that we can listen to the recording, we can bring it into our own playing, and it'll only enhance.
I wanted to ask the rhythm section, in your rehearsals, do you pretty much play just like this, like in this format, or like how do you sit when you, or how do you play?
Piano's usually like right there.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, and then there's like three of us.
Drums are right behind guitars.
Or let me get to what I want to ask you. Do y'all look at each other when you play in rehearsal?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's maybe just this setup where
yeah.
You can't really see each other?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I would love to see you guys communicate, and there's nothing that says Jen's ordering the two guitar players to sit right smack here in the front, you know, like you could get up and you could, you know, look at each other, because like what I missed in the rhythm section was a sense of it being alive, like being in the moment, right? And that's a step you have to take forward as far as like to not be afraid to do that and feel like, you know, am I allowed to get off the script a little bit? Like, is that okay? Like, yeah, it is, okay? So maybe just learning how you guys can communicate with each other visually a little bit more and play off each other a little bit more. I can sit down with, like if you guys want to play something through again, I'm cool, like I'd love to sit down and play a couple things with you to just kind of help you, because you have, you're playing in a little box over there, you're like playing it safe, you know? It's cool, you have more power that you could access from there. So. Staying in communication with one another, trying not to be in a box of like, okay, I'm playing my part. Like, you guys have the, you know, the dynamic thing or the you know, instigating the soloist thing. Those are things that are the next step for you guys to make the music live and make it be active and alive and different every time. You're allowed to do that. I hope I can say that.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. You're allowed to do that.
And just so you know, our pianist couldn't come. Matt is actually the third guitarist. He's
what?
I'm a classical
guitarist.
So,
he learned it all.
And piano right now.
And playing piano now.
Yeah.
So,
I would have not known that at all. Like,
Cool.
I want to quickly tag off something that you just said. I felt like everyone was stuck in their stance.
Yeah.
And trombone players, I'm gonna pick on you because I'm a trombone player. Why are y'all playing with your stance that low? All of you were facing right down to the ground, and when there were these really great solo sections that I wanted to hear you out, everyone was literally facing the ground. So lift your stance up, please, and thank you. Lift them up and move them where your bell is facing out on the sides. I know there's probably not that much space, but even if you just pulled up the stand. Because there was so much playing down, and I really wanted to hear everyone's sound. So, like, I usually play with my bell facing out on the left side. And so that way I have space, I have room. I know this configuration isn't the most cohesive and conducive to not playing the ground, but everyone, every song was playing the ground. So that was just one of my big things. It was really, I was like hurting a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't know about y'all, but I was like, no, I want to hear everyone. I guess jumping into our second selection.
Yeah.
I want to make sure we touch on all of them.
And we will do some playing, hopefully.
Yeah.
Just wanted to go over
this. So this is the one that there is the beginning. Everyone was playing in unison on the same part. Particularly, I'm gonna harp quickly on trombone, bass, Barry, piano, guitar. All together, I felt like you were playing the part, but no one was playing it the same way. And so I was hearing two very different things, and it could also been again. The stance side of things. But in rehearsals, have you guys ever rehearsed with having your Barry and your bass trombone rehearsing next to your bass player?
No.
I think you should do that occasionally.
Okay.
I'm not saying
yeah.
all the time, but you don't have to shake the wheel all the way. This is my favorite rehearsal strategy for the low end because you don't always get to be next to each other.
Mm.
You're always on the opposite side of the room. So sometimes it's hard to really reconnect back with what your rhythm section's doing, and I think that's one of my favorite rehearsal strategies is when you actually get to flip the room so you can hear what's happening, so change that balance. So if you are able to do that, do
okay.
it. It's a lot of fun. It makes everyone confused because they don't know where to sit. but I think it's gonna go a really long way in terms of like getting that cohesiveness together as you play these little notes together. I was gonna say that the breaks that were happening, it felt like there was some uncertainty that was happening. And just overall balance while the guitar had their solo, I felt like I didn't realize you were doing a solo at first. So the balance was like, I didn't realize what was happening. And I was like, oh, I'm listening to a solo right now. So when there is, when you are playing, like.
I was so ready for that and I turned it up and then.
It's okay and it happens, but I just want to make sure that your section, as they support you, realizes that you're soloing and adjusts accordingly.
Okay.
So that's it's not a call on you. I'm not saying that's on
you. Playing the classical guitars.
Yeah.
I think that's a good point. Because, you know, even you said there was something wrong with your amp or what was going on?
No, I turned it up all the way, and I guess I didn't.
You know, but see, that's the beautiful thing, right? We should be able to adjust.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean,
it doesn't matter what happens. Not saying you, we want our rhythm section, we want to be able to adjust no matter what. I mean, we do that in life all the time, right? What happens if you get up in the morning and you want it to where your favorite pair of pants and you realize that they were dirty, what are you going to do? Absolutely. Stay home. Right. But you see what I'm saying? We make those adjustments, right? So we should be able to make those adjustments in music. It's all relative. It really is all relative.
Yeah.
It really is. You know what I would like to say? I'm not messing with the drummers because I love you guys. Your bass drum is really hard. Has any of your teachers
yep.
talked to you about feathering
yep.
the bass drum?
Oh.
My
private instructor told me just like hammer your, just have it light, and then if you want to accent like a part, then accent it out.
You know, I think that you know when you're like playing your bombs and your accents were actually not conducive to the band. Do you know what I'm saying? It was louder than the band. So this is, again, things that, okay, well, hold on. I don't need to play that loud because look who I'm playing. They're not good. We were really playing together. Also, don't feel, this is for both of you, don't feel that you always have to set up one. You know, 12 bar phrases, we don't always have to, on the 12th bar, bam, you don't have to do that all the time. You know, sometimes you can just play through the phrase, and if you do want to set it up, you can set it up very, you can make it very, very light, okay? You know, time, I'm a stickler for time. Whose job is it in the big band setting? Whose job is it? Who is the time keeper? Can someone tell me?
Everybody?
Would you agree that it's the drummer?
Yeah.
You're all wrong.
Yes.
You're all wrong. You and you and you and you and you. You guys are the timekeepers. You are the timekeepers. You are the timekeepers. And that is so serious. There's nothing, oh man, it's a drag if you're, and you should, you guys are doing, it's a drag if you have to be the timekeeper. That is a drag for a drummer. Because no one else has good time and you had to be the one. No. So we all should, every time that we practice, we should have that. What is that thing called? I forgot. Right. We should always be practicing with that metronome. Okay? Always. Always, always. I know it's a drag sometimes, but your time is so important. Because when you're in time, then you can play with the time. And you're listening to what's going on around you, and you can react to what's going on around you, as opposed to just playing yourself and just being in your own world. You can actually be part of the entire musical production or whatever. Okay? Andy? This dude is playing lead and soloing.
Our lead player can play, he's actually our second as well. And he's a classical French horn. Just throwing that out there.
Where are you going to school? You're going to UNT, right? Plug in there. Actually, all of you are going to UNT is going to college. We'll talk about that later. You're doing a great job. I mean, you're doing it all, right? And you're adjusting. I like the fact that you're doing all that. Right? That's a good job. That's all I wanted to say.
You're just like laying down all these like facts on us today where we're like, wait, what?
That's how we roll.
I was gonna try to go out of my way to not mention it.
Right.
I'm like just like a flabbergasted. Clearly, I'm like, wow.
But yeah, that's what I have to say. Oh man, you guys sound good.
Do you want to go to the boat?
Yeah.
You want to go to caravan?
Yeah, let's go to caravan.
Yeah. Okay. So awesome that you have a singer working with you. I can tell a couple things that you're really listening to that recording, which is awesome, and you've got some really nice sounds going on. Your voice is beautiful. It's a strong instrument with a gorgeous tone. Are you singing in choir, or are you doing vocal jazz? What are you doing?
No, I really just asked if I could like come with, because I'm classical.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm like a super soprano, like I sing classical music, like only, and I've never done this before. So
oh.
I was just
told you were a soprano.
I know, I
yourself to singing up there, because
yeah.
a lot of voice teachers will put you up there.
Yeah.
You don't need, you can do, you could do lots of things.
Yeah, I was really excited because I was like, I never get to sing like down here.
No, your tone is gorgeous.
Yeah.
So a couple things, you don't have to be like them as far as in the sense that you have a stand in the music. The singer is always kind of like expected, it's our gig, like we kind of
yeah.
just, you know, we're good to know the tune, you know? So know the tune, don't be afraid to take that mic off the thing and go stand in the front. You're allowed to do that because you're the you're the focus visually and you're leading the melody. You're the soloist, so you know like when the horn players stand up,
yeah.
you just walk right to the front. That's your job.
Yeah.
Yeah, and your job also is, I mean, it's just a singer thing. We always memorize our tunes, especially
right.
a tune like Caravan. Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah. So cool with that. And then just, do you play piano at all?
A little bit.
A little bit?
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay, so that melody has got that nice chromatic movement at the end of it, of each section. I would get in there with the piano and really nail that down.
Yeah.
Because that melody is pretty specific and it's a great
yes.
melody, but it needs a little bit of chromatic attention. And then that melody, don't let, it's got to be that a major third note, minor third.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, and everybody loves to hear that sound, so. It is an amazing tune. I think you're doing a great job. The way to take it to the next level is get rid of the stand, memorize the tune, don't be afraid to be a leader.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah. You guys, it's great to have a singer with the band.
Yeah.
You know? Do any of you sing?
They would kill him on that.
You do?
Yeah.
Good. I'd love to have you all say, mm-hmm.
mm-hmm.
Who was it that, the Brubeck brothers, the kids that played the other night on the main stage, the bass player. Did you hear his solo when he sang and played? He got right on the mic and sang exactly what he played. Did you hear this the other night? This was
Chris.
Thursday night when the Brubeck sons played, family band played. The bass player is amazing. You should go check him out down in the exhibition hall. But he got right on the mic and the second halfway through his solo, he sang everything he played.
Wow.
Singing is a really... Don't think just because you're an instrumentalist that that's just the choir thing. I would encourage you all to learn some sight singing and singing choir for a while because it will make you closer to your instrument. And then some, you know, when you transcribe solos, don't go right to the pencil on the paper. Don't do that. Don't even look at the notes. Like if you got a transcription book, don't do that. Listen to the recording and sing it back. Listen to the recording and sing it back. Listen to the recording and sing it back before you even touch your instrument.
Mm-hmm.
Singing is like, it's like the drums. It's like the first number two instruments in the whole world. It's really critical and vital. And to have a sense of camaraderie and respect between the instrumentalists and the singers is a really good and healthy thing. And I want you to keep that with you because there's going to be times and places where that's not always the case. And I want you to be renegades against that. I want you to work with, you guys should do a vocal jazz set along with the band, like, you know, put the whole thing together if you have, or the choir, or something like that, do some sacred big band choir stuff. You know, it's just really good to stay cohesive with that instrument, and the more you all can sing, go take a semester of choir, or do both, or something like that, or have a chart that they all sing on, or something like that, in addition to playing. It's just a really great, it adds to your musicianship. Yeah, it really adds to your musicianship to be able to sing. What was the gal that sang that night? She ended with that dirgy song, but she just freaking killed it. What was that gal's name? She played trumpet?
Bria Skonberg.
Holy crap.
Wasn't she so good? Yeah, that was like, yeah, that was transcendent.
Uh-huh,
yeah.
It was, huh? Singing and playing, that's where it's at. So. Lots of respect here. She's got an amazing instrument. What the hell is
that? Oh my god. I feel like I'm having an identity crisis.
Yeah. Okay, I'm done.
I might even just jump over because
yeah.
I love it.